Hi there, welcome to the new part of Azure DevOps tutorial. In this part, we will learn something about the projects. What are the projects? How to create a project? How to view the project? How to delete the project? So basically, we are going to learn lots of things about the projects in Azure DevOps. Let's start. First of all, let's have a look what is the agenda of this video. In this video, we will learn what is a project, what types of project we can create in Azure DevOps, how to create a new project on Azure DevOps, how to view already created project, and then at the last we will see what are the settings which are available for the project in Azure DevOps. First of all, let's have a look what is the project. A project is a place where actual complete product development is done by the team. Everything which is required for the development of a particular software is available in the project. Let's see what is that. A project provides a repository for source code. So basically, if you are working on the software development, then you have to work on the code. So we have a repository for the source code management and a place for a group of people. So basically, the group of people means the team. In your team, there may be multiple members or there may be single members depending on the type of the project, to plan, track progress and collaborate on building software solutions. So basically, these are the important steps for the software development, and all these things are available under the project. All the data related to a software is stored under a project. So everything which is related to the project, just like the code, the task, the stories, the bug, all those things, test plans, continuous integration, all those things which is available for the project is stored under the project. Each project must have an organization. Just like we have learned in the previous video, for each project, there must be at least one organization. A project provides us all the main services of Azure DevOps. So basically, these are the main services: repo, boards, pipeline, test plan, and the artifacts. If we create a new project, then we will see all these five properties, all these five services under the project. By default, a team with same name, just like the name of the project, is created when we create a new project. So whenever we will create a new project, a new team will be created with the same name of the project. Before creating a new project, let's understand what are the different type of projects in the Azure DevOps. In Azure DevOps, there are two type of projects. First one is public project, second one is private projects. Let's have a look on these two types in detail. First, we will learn about the public project. Since it is clear from the name that these projects are publicly open because this is public, so if we create a new public project, then these things will happen. Public projects are visible to everyone. Each person who can access the internet can see your project. No login is required to get access of the public project. In order to view the public project, there is no login required. You simply need the URL of that project. You can simply put the URL of the project in your browser, and all the things which are related to that project will be available to everyone. Each public project has a unique URL. So basically, you, in order to access the project, you must need a URL, and in Azure DevOps, each project has a unique URL. Now let's see what is the use of public projects. Public projects are mostly used for open source project development. Open source project is something which is visible to everyone. So just like that, we can create public project and we can start the development in public project for the open source project. We can create unlimited number of public projects under one or more organizations. Now let's have a look what is private project. If we create a new private project, then private projects are visible to limited users. So basically, these projects are visible to only those users to whom you will provide some access. User must login into Azure DevOps portal to access the project. Each project has a unique URL. Private projects are mostly used for non-public software development. So if you are working in an organization, or you are the organization where you want to keep your things private, so you can choose a private project and you can start the development on the private project. Now let's have a look how can we create a new project on Azure DevOps. To create a new project on Azure DevOps, first you have to open the Azure DevOps portal in your browser and you have to log in using your account in the Azure DevOps portal. So this is the URL dev.azure.com. Once you will log in into the application, you will see the organizations on the left side. The first step is you must choose an organization. So you have to choose under what organization you are going to create a new project. So suppose I'm going to create a new project under this one, Nitish Web Central. So this is the organization. This organization does not have any project right now. I am going to create first project under this organization. Whenever you will click on this organization, you will see a pop-up on the right side like this. Or if your organization already has a project just like this one, so here I already have a new project. If I need to create a new one, I have to click over here on the create project button. Okay, so suppose let's create a new project under this one, webgentle-sample.org. So I'm going to click on this one. So here I'm going to create a new project. First I have to enter the name of the project. So suppose this is the name of the project, WebGentle Sample Mobile Application. And then you have to enter the description for this project over here. Then you have to choose the visibility. Visibility means the type of the project. So you have to choose whether you are going to create a public project or you are going to create a private project. So suppose I'm going to create a public project. So I will click on the public. Here you will see there is one more dropdown which says advanced. If you click on it, then you will see first you have the version control. Let's see what is available under this version control. Here you can see there are two things. First is Git and the second one is TFS. So basically whenever you will be working with the source code, there are two type of things to manage your code. First one is Git and second one is TFS. You can choose any one of them as per your requirement or your need. Suppose by default I'm using Git. And then on the second dropdown you will see work item progress. So basically if you will click on this, you will see there are four options. First one is Agile, Basic, CMMI and then Scrum. These are basically the work item process. The board of the project depends on the option which you will choose from this dropdown. So suppose by default I'm clicking on the Basic. We will learn all these types one by one in the later part of this tutorial. So for now, suppose I'm choosing the basic one. If I choose basic and click create, a new project will be created for us. There we go. So we have a new working project for us. Here on the left side, you can see all the main services of this project. First we have overview, then we have boards, repo, pipelines, test plan, and the artifacts. All these features are available for this project. This is the home base for this project and these are the services. Let's see all the services one by one because there is nothing in the project right now. So there is nothing in the services also. If you will click on the boards, you will see a completely blank board is available. If you will click on the repos, you will see there is nothing in the repos. Then we have the pipelines. Everything is completely blank. Test plan, there is nothing in the test plan. And if I click on the artifacts, then you will see there is nothing in the artifacts also. So basically we are learning how to create a new project and this is how you can create a new project. Okay, one more thing. Suppose you have already created a new project and now you want to see where is that project. So suppose I'm here on the organization tab, Nitish Web Central. If I want to access the project which I have created just now, for that first I have to click on the organizations. In the organizations, you will see all the projects which are available under this one are here. So this is the project which we have created just now. If I click on this one, you will see we are on the same project. Now let's see what settings are available for the project. To access the settings of this project, you have to click here on the bottom left part of this page, project settings. So these settings are available in the project details. If you want to update the name of your project, then you can update it over here. If you want to update the description, then you can update the description also. Then the process. So basically the basic process is available. That's why it is showing the basic. Here is the visibility. If you need to update the visibility of your project, then you can do it. If you want to make it private, then you can choose the private and click on the save button. You will see the project is not visible to everyone. And if I click on the public one, then now you can access this project from your own browser also. How? So this is the URL. Suppose I'm going to open this URL in a new browser in Google Intro tab. So you can see this is the incognito tab, and I haven't logged in into the application. Still, I can see all the details of this project in my browser. If I make it private, let's make it private and click on the save button. And if I try to refresh this one, you will see the Azure DevOps portal is asking for the login because this is private right now. Let's make it public. Here you can see all the project administrator. Since I am the only user in this application right now, so I am the administrator of this project. You can add more administrator also if you want to. Then here are the Azure DevOps services. All these services are available for this project. So since you can see all of them are on, that's why all of them are available for this project. Let's open this project in the another tab. Okay, here you can see all the services. Now let's remove one of them. So suppose I do not want to work on the Azure boards, so I want to remove that. To remove it, you can click over here, and whenever you will click on the remove boards, the boards will be removed from your project. Let's refresh this one over here. So you will see the board is not available under this project. Okay, that's how you can enable or disable the particular service for your project. Let's enable it back. And here you will see we got the boards again. Okay, so delete project. If you want to delete your project, then you can click on the delete button and your project will be deleted. What teams are available under this project? You can see all the information here in the teams tab. So right now we have only one team, which is WebGentle sample mobile application team, and this default team is created when we create a new project. If I click on this one, you can see all the members of team are available over here. So since we have only one user, we will learn how to add new members in the team in the later part of this video tutorial. And for now, you can see all the teams which are available under this project are over here. You can add more than one team also in your one project. Here is the security tab. For the security, all the teams are available over here and all the Azure DevOps groups. So basically, if you want to update the access for a particular user or the group, you can manage all these things here in the security tab. Notifications. If you want to receive the notification on a particular action in your Azure DevOps, then you can manage all these things over here. Suppose you want to receive the notification for the build complete, then you can click on the on tab and you will receive all the notifications in your email ID. So here are all the things. So the Git one, for the Git pull request whenever the reviewer is added or removed, pull request changes, all these things, the notifications is managed here in the notification tab. Service hooks. So there is nothing right now, but we will learn all these things in the later part when we will have something in our project. Then we have the dashboard. Only team administrator can set a team permission for all the dashboards. The permission set here affect all the dashboard for this team. So basically, create dashboard, who can create the dashboard, who can edit the dashboards, who can delete the dashboard. This is something which is related to the permission of the dashboards. Then we have the board details, we have the pipeline detail and the repository detail, and then the test plans. All the things which you want to manage for your project, you can access all of them from here. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Tell me your feedback in the comment section, share this video and subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.